Welcome to Jallikattu, Tamil Nadu's most controversial sport. In 2017, after thousands gathered in protest at the Marina in Chennai and tens of thousands more across Tamil Nadu, conducting Jallikattu became legal again. Oh, sorry, let me start from the beginning. It's almost impossible to imagine Tamil Nadu as it was a few thousand years ago. But Sangam literature from that time allows us beautiful glimpses of the agrarian culture, the four types of landscapes, and of course, the Jallikattu sport from 2300 years ago. Jallikattu is the colloquial corruption of the word Sallikattu. Salli means coins and kattu is that string bag that's still popular in villages in South India today. It refers to the bag of coins tied to the horns of the bull, which contestants had to get hold of, or at least try. The sport was also called Yer Taruvudal, which means hugging the bull, which stands on each side and a narrow pathway softened with ploughed earth. The bull is allowed to run from the Vadivasal, an opening or arch, through the passageway where the contestants try to hug the bull from the flanks and hold on to it for a few seconds. Today the count is a minimum of 7 seconds. Hold on to the bull for 7 seconds and you win. Tamil culture, as with agrarian traditions across India, shares a special bond with the cow, bull and the domestic hen. Of the 15 or so different breeds of cattle once thriving in the state, only 7 or 8 survive. Through generations of selective breeding and animal husbandry, the farmers created and strengthened these breeds, some of which yield milk, others which take to ploughing like its second nature, and a few more who can carry huge loads with ease. The pinnacle or top model of each breed, so to speak, is the Jallikattu bull, raised for the sport and used for breeding as a stud bull once the bull retires at the age of 8 or 9 years. There have been repeated attempts to ban the sport due to complaints of cruelty against the animals for about 2 decades now, and for good reason. Between 2008 and 14, when the sport was banned, 43 humans and 4 bulls died in avoidable circumstances. In the standoff between the Supreme Court, animal rights activists and the farmers, much has happened since 2014. Jallikattu is now a legal sport, again in Tamil Nadu, thanks to the statewide protests that erupted in 2017 in January. But the sport since then has become a symbol of Tamil pride, a trope that is being used by politicians across the state to claim ownership of that elusive concept of Tamil identity. With due consultation and consideration with and to the farmers, who are the real stakeholders, the sport needs to be made safer for both man and bull. That's the only way it can survive for a few generations more. And on that note, a happy Pongal and Jallikattu to you.